Oh my god, like just oh my god. You can now just play the whole world in 3D inside of Unity. Like the whole world. Imagine all the things that you can do with it. It's insane, dude. So like Google just announced photorealistic 3D tiles. You can now just play the entire world inside of Unity. And that's insane. So I was just trying it out and it's awesome, I think. Let's just get into it. So first of all, we of course need Unity. So I'm assuming you have a little bit of experience, but if not, would you just install the Unity Hub, install the editor, make sure you're in the latest version. Currently, I'm working in this one. So make sure you have it. Let's click new project. And we're just gonna do some 3D universal render pipeline. This works in HDRP, but let's keep it in universal. So yeah, let's create our project. And meanwhile, we also need to prepare our Google Maps account and our Cesium account. So for that, click the link below. So you're gonna get this prompt message. You can just fucking sign up with Epic Games or whatever to be quick. You're just gonna sign up, okay? That's about all you need to do. So first of all, we need to install Cesium. So for that, first we're gonna go here, edit project settings. And we're gonna click package manager, okay? Now we're gonna add a new scope registry. You have in the description below the URL and all that stuff for you to copy. You just copy this, you get here like the name, the URL, and the scope. You press save, you just wait a little bit, and now it's installed. We can now go to the package manager, and here, you're just gonna click here and choose my registry. So now here we had Cesium for Unity and you're gonna click install. We're just gonna wait a little bit, it's not that long. And we're gonna get asked to restart Unity, so we're gonna agree with that. So we click restart, yes, we wait a little bit. Okay, so Unity has restarted now. And we can see here that we have now a new tab here, okay? So we're gonna press Cesium, and right now I'm connected, but you're gonna see a big button here that says like login to your account. You're gonna press it, you're gonna get redirected to your browser, and you're gonna log in. And you need to allow all the permissions necessary, okay? Now you're gonna get back here, and now we need to get the new Google Maps API. So for that, we're gonna go into the Google Maps platform. It's gonna be linked in the description below. And you're gonna need to register yourself in the console cloud. Here you're gonna create a new project or choose a new one. For here, I'm gonna create a new project. I'm gonna call it whatever, tutorial. I'm gonna create it. I'm gonna wait a little bit. Right on, we're just prompted with my API key. You just click the button to copy it. Okay, and you just click it. Now, the functionality API that we're gonna use, it's not activated by default. We're gonna click here, API, and here you see the active APIs and the not active. So we're gonna press Arial View and we're gonna click. And also here, we're gonna search for the map tiles API, and we're gonna enable it. So cool, now my map tiles is enabled and my aerial view is enabled. And we're gonna head back to Unity. Okay, right here, we're gonna press token here and we're gonna create a new token here. Click create and now we have our token created. So cool, now the next step is to actually create the map. So we're gonna go here and we're gonna create a blank 3D tile set. We're gonna press the plus button and we're gonna get two game objects here. So now nothing is shown yet, but we need to adjust some things. Okay, first of all, we're gonna get show credits on screen in order to comply with Google's privacy policies. Now in Tileset source, we're gonna check from URL, okay? And inside the URL, we're gonna copy the URL that I provide you. And in the end, you need to put the maps API key. Okay, so that's the key that we just got from Google and that we just copied, and we're just gonna paste it right here, okay? But with that done, you should start seeing things appear on screen. You can see it right now. We are here And it's awesome, no? I'm already seeing some awesome things. Okay, but what if I just want a specific place to be? Oh, we're just gonna go to our viable Google Maps, and I'm just gonna search for Los Angeles, for example. We're gonna click here, we're gonna go into a cool place, for example here. And I'm just gonna put a marker down. And here I can get the coordinates. So I'm gonna copy that, put it right here on the latitude, and copy that other one, put it on the longitude. So now we can absolutely see that we are there. Now for the height, you just need to test it out. Hi, Excel from the future. Actually, you can just look into Google Earth and add a marker there, and you can check the height over there. So yeah, sorry. So now we are here. Let's go somewhere we like. I like this place to be my origin point, and we're gonna place origin here. So now all of my origin points will be right here. So that's awesome. We can even move to another place and just put it over there. Just put this origin here. So that's cool. And here, like, we can now get the whole world, but that's not all. If we just press play, nothing is gonna actually happen because we're not testing anything. We're just gonna see the map. So if you wanna watch in a simple way, you can just go back to the CCM tab. You can just add a dynamic camera. So now that dynamic camera by default is gonna look awesome, but first I'll recommend you upping this a little bit more so that it doesn't load in that much time. For like 40, it's okay, I guess. And now make sure you delete your main camera and let's press play to test it. Here you can test it, you can turn around, and hey, there we go. We are inside of Unity, just scouting around this area, just looking at the streets, looking, and that's not even the fucking best thing. You can just get on top and actually see the whole world. Like, you can move any place you like. Like, you tell me if this is not awesome. You can just explore the whole world, like the extremely whole world, just inside of Unity. And that's not all. Now let's go further. So here you would think that if I just add a random object, it's gonna stay on place, but the reality is that it doesn't work that way. You can see that it looks weird. And why is that? That's because my dynamic camera is actually just not rendering all, but is just pivoted to the camera. So here you can see what's happening. My camera is right here, and if I move, my actual player is not moving. Like, the actual whole city is the one that it's moving, right? So Google has provided us with some awesome features. So let's look at it. So the first one is called create subscene. So subscenes is an actual way to create a zone in a map to just display global scale experience things and locations. So let's try it out. Let's start by moving our scene camera to a place where we want to create a subscene. For example, let's create it right here. So let's press create subscene here and rename this subscene area 1. Here we can see that it has created a big circle. So that's the zone of the map that is gonna be the subscene. Okay, so every time we enter that zone of the map, it's gonna render and display all of our objects inside of this object in the actual global transformation. So that's awesome. We can here decrease the radius if we want it to be a little bit smaller. Let's see, 500. So here for testing purposes, I'm gonna press it like a 20, just so I can show you things. So now we have created this subscene. Here we can see what is happening. Okay, so if I'm up here, you can see my camera moving here. Okay, and you can see that now the cube is staying on the position. Okay, but if I just start moving way out of the zone, now you can see that it disappears. Okay, so what it's doing is that when I'm out of the zone, the map is the one that is shifting and moving, but once I enter the zone, now it's not. Now I'm the player who is moving. So that's awesome. So I can now add some stuff, create some other things in a global space. So yeah, let me just have some fun. I'm gonna expand the radius to 40 and I'm just gonna add some quick cubes, quick stuff you can import. Okay, so here now I have added some simple stuff and you can see that it absolutely works. Obviously you can take a bit more time, but I just imported whatever I had and it's really awesome. So if I go a certain way, it disappears. Now, it's very important that all of the things that you just added, you just put it inside of the area. Why is that? Because here we can see that if we just leave it outside of the area, whenever we leave the zone, the objects are just gonna keep being there. So it's gonna look absolutely weird just having a card right there. So we need to have these objects inside of the area for it in order to disappear also when we are out of the area. So now, if we just move outside of the area, the object just disappears. So that's really awesome. And now you can leave it here, but we can go one step further. So first of all, just let me increase the area size just to have a little bit more room to work. And we can actually just import the started assets, make a simple third person character game. So let's just import the started asset, link it in the description. We just hit import, we're just gonna import everything and there you go. We can just simply disable our dynamic camera because we don't need it anymore. And we're just gonna search for the prefabs. We're gonna drag our main camera, our player follow camera and our player armature. So they are right here. So now we're just gonna click the player follow camera and in the follow reference, we're gonna drag the player camera root. Now let's click play and you can see that we just go below the ground. Now you might think that our map doesn't have any collision, but it does. It actually have a mesh collider. So what is happening here is that our map is taking a lot to load. So the player falls. So for this, we can just maybe move our character up until it loads. And maybe we could also increase the screen space error for it to load faster, like let's say 50, so that it loads a little bit faster. Let's place our player even higher and I'm gonna test it. So here we go. Now we're inside of this. And I think it's just awesome that even all of the collisions are just already there. So I think this has a lot of potential and it's super easy and quick to do. Like imagine if you just start building upon this, like you just refine some buildings, add some more geometry, create even interactions. So that's awesome. You now have basically a one-to-one representation of the world inside of Unity. You can explore the whole world. Please link every project you do with this in the comments below. I'm willing to watch every single one of you. I'm gonna keep experimenting with this and I'm also gonna do a tutorial for how to import it to Unreal Engine. Let me know if you're interested and see you later, guys.